Hey everyone, Symbiote here, and welcome back to Let's Play The Sims 3 Aurora Skies. Now, technically, this would be part 13, but this is actually going to be sort of an extension of my university life Let's Play. So now that the Monta Vista girls have gone back home, we're going to be carrying on university with Parvati here and Verity, who is currently in class. And right now I've got Parvati heading to the roasted toasted coffee beans so that she can grab something to eat, because you can see she's pretty hungry. Before we actually get started, I wanted to mention a few things. The first of which is that I can't say how lucky I am to have so many people who've come to watch my videos and comment and subscribe, and I truly am so grateful. And it makes me so happy, and I'm so touched to just be a part of your lives and have you all watch and be supportive and all of that. So, you know, I'm going to do my best to continue to, you know, put out my best work and get better and learn and all of those things. What's kind of cool is that, firstly, I'm very close to, well, I'm close-ish to 1,000 subscribers. I passed 800 yesterday, I think, and now I'm at like 816, 817. And I know I mentioned before we were going to be doing a giveaway. When I get to 1,000, we'll be doing a bigger giveaway than I had planned on doing at 500. So I'll be able to give somebody like a world or something. But I mean, I can't give too much, but like I'm going to figure it out so that everybody has a fair shot. Sorry, I was just like looking at the back of her shoes. So that everybody has a shot to get, you know, a good shot at getting something and all of that. I have a little bit of a migraine right now, but I'm recording because I'm way behind and I haven't done Aurora Skies and I miss these girls and all that. So anyway. And kind of relating to the whole, you know, getting so many subscribers and views and things like that, because you guys are great. I was lucky enough to be signed to the Full Screen Arcade the Full Screen Arcade subsidiary of Full Screen Network on YouTube. So I'm going to be putting out regular content, and that's going to give me, you know, they're going to give me more of an opportunity to grow. And I just want you to know that, I mean, this is a possibility for me to actually start making some money, and you have all made that possible for me. Honestly, you have all made that possible for me. I have been disabled since 2006, and in that time, I have not been able to make, you know, any money. I've been sick. I can't work in a traditional environment, and I have, you know, there are reasons that I can't do most other jobs, and I've been looking for something I can do at home. And I started this on a whim, and I started it to have fun. And I'm still having fun, and I'm having such a great time communicating with you all and doing this. And now I actually have a hope of, you know, contributing. And, okay, oh my god, I'm getting a little choked up. Thank you. Thank you all. sorry. So, yeah. So that's that. The giveaway, full screen. This has all been a really great opportunity, and, yes, so thank you. And anyway, oh man, okay, sorry about that. Anyway, we've got poor Parvati waiting here. She's so hungry, so we're gonna have her run up and grab something to eat before she goes to class. I haven't had any of them get a bagel yet, so let's do that. And Verity we'll probably be done with class pretty soon. But I've got her working hard. Because she's a tough cookie, and she's only got one class today. Parvati has another class. Now, if you remember correctly, Parvati is in the... Parvati is in the business major because, you know, she works at the school, she's in the education career, and she may or may not have a future as like a superintendent or something. And you know, she feels as though this might actually help her out with like bookkeeping and things like that. Now, in a logistical sense, in a real world meta sense, it's not actually going to help her that much in her career, but you know, like, part, in a game sense, story-wise, Parvati feels that this is the best option, and Verity is going to school for communication. She loves writing. She's a talented writer, and she may go into journalism. Who knows? I don't know what we're going to do with her yet, but I'm sure it will be great, because she is a smarty smart and really cool, and yeah, I think she's going to do well. She actually has an opportunity right now. So she has to visit 25 Frame Cinema. Actually, let's go back to Parvati. That'll be more interesting to look at. And she wants to raise her charisma. We can have her... Oh, she's being helpful putting that there. We can have her talk to somebody. Who's this? Nicole Lowry. She looks like a vampire. Why don't you go talk to her? And because she needs to make friends in order to raise her charisma skill and all of that, etc. Who's this? Skip Taylor. Walter Fullman. To me, Helia was like, Helia was just so asocial when she was here. She made all of these friends, but not by choice. I don't think she was really that interested in connecting with any of them. Okay, so foreign films. Okay, let's pause this for a sec, because I can't remember what she's supposed to do. Okay, so it's due by Tuesday at like 11:58 p.m., so almost midnight. And, excuse me, I have hiccups. Okay, there we go. All right. Foreign films provide a great outlet for esoteric rebellious behavior, and it just so happens that the 25 Frame Cinema is providing a marathon of the most morose foreign films to date. It's kind of funny, because recently I watched Anatomy of Hell. Don't Netflix it. Just don't. All right. So... yeah, we'll have Parvati work on her communications and all of that. In order to do... Now, I'm sure if you've watched other LPs, you've seen all of this. But in order to work on it, like, you have to... For her, she needs to raise charisma and social networking. And even just by talking to people and getting to know them, everything goes up. Get to know. So that is... Like, her academic performance will improve just by her doing that. We'll also have her start a blog about, you know, maybe... I don't know, it'd be kind of cliche to have her do, like, single motherhood or something like that, so, not that I think that's bad, but you know what I mean. So we might have her blog about something else, you know, maybe getting her groove back or something like that. She's gonna praise, and we really need to work on getting some of those, compliment dancing, yeah, that works. We have to have her work on getting some of, those skill challenges that you get. Excuse me, I'm just in my brain. Those skill challenges that you get, because that'll give you, like, a starting bonus and things like that. Okay, she thinks that Parvati is being boring. Friendly, apologize. Oh my god, this girl is work. It's like, I'm so sorry for saying that you're super cool and awesome. I won't try that again. Okay. Ask about alma mater. We gotta keep to sort of neutral territory. Then she's gonna think we're being boring. This is Sid Cerberus all over again. Okay. Okay, girl, you are work. Pass. Let's go talk to this dude. Louis Rogers. Go be nice to him. And we'll have her work. Oh, her stuff is going down now. Yeah, she has to attend class, study, do her exams, and like I said, social networking and charisma. When is her class? I think her next class is at 4, yes. So she'll be going to class and doing her thing. Verity is on her way home. She's stressed out. I don't know if we have any parties that have come up, but I think I want to have her go do her cinema thing. So actually, let's pause really quickly. And boop 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 boop. Alright. Can she go? She needs to go between 6 and 11:59. So, alright, we'll plan for her to go at 6. And in the interim, we will watch as she runs in those heels so expertly. Be asked for money. Is she standing out here getting soaking wet so that this one person can ask her for money? Okay, and she's gone to class. She's going to be in a bad mood when she gets out of school. That's okay. We'll see how much she can handle. Now, I'm going to gussy up their rooms and Oh, okay, she's gonna get soaking wet. Go home. Yeah, we're gonna make their rooms look a little nicer and all of that, because they do have a fair amount of money. But of course, that money, when they go back to Aurora Skies, that money has to, like, you know, get them through. And obviously, when they go back, they can't continue living in that tiny house, so we're gonna have to do something for them. That looked like a cicada or something. Like, are we gonna have a swarm of locusts? That'd be sucky. Alright, now, what can we have her, excuse me, what can we have her do? Play hopscotch? No. Sing karaoke? No. What's a pillow fight with somebody? And learn the painting skill and upgrade something and buy a portable nub set. Well, we can do the portable nub set right now. Entertainment. Alright. There we go. Oh, I even found it. Usually, it's right at the top, but usually I never find it at first. Come on. There's got to be a spot over here. I might have to move. Okay. We're going to move this bad boy. So that's like right. There we go. And I know that I'm going to have to repaint the ground now, but oh well. Oh well. All right. Put that there. Perfect. Let's see how much closer I can move this. That's a little bit better. Now it won't be right in the way of the diving board. Oof, okay. There we go. And see, now she's happy. We can set this wish. She wants to pillow fight. Who's here? Come here, Gongum. Greet. Has she not even talked to her yet? This girl throws too many parties. Okay, I know you're hungry, but usually you can pillow fight with, like, anybody, ever. Let's have her ask about day first. Oh, fine, go eat. We're gonna have her listen to a photography tabcast, because that's something she has to read. And then she needs to work on writing. Unfortunately, her writing is maxed. So I think by having her write something, it'll help. Why don't you read? Yeah. Because what you write, like, if you read, then the things you write end up being better. That's probably something you already know, but, you know. Just in case. Alright, yeah, she's at class. She's working hard. Let's have her text some friends so that she's not so stressed. It's her performance going up, yeah. And this is the first day of class. We have a lot of time to make sure their grades are up. But I'll be honest, I just did the business career, the business major with my 100 baby sim. And, like, it's a pain in the ass. It really is. Maybe I'm just not good at that one, but it's kind of a pain. But, let's speed this up a little bit. Interestingly, okay, yeah, one thing to mention is, speaking of the 100 Baby Challenge, you should totally check it out, because Betsy's Five Avengers and I are going to be doing it jointly. So, you know, it'll just be like, almost like it's not going to be a live stream, but yeah, we'll both be doing the 100 Baby Challenge, and it's going to be sort of a speed run. So I think that'll be cool, because I had the Sim, who's going to be sort of starring in the LP. She's going to be the one having all of these babies. She went to university first. She got a degree, and she can't actually work, but she writes comic books for a living, which is neat. So, you know, that's something, and I think it's going to be interesting to watch, so I recommend that you check it out. All right, let's have her go to the film screening, and let's have Parvati come home. And she can eat veggie rolls. Eat some veggie rolls. It's not that late and everybody's exhausted and cranky. I didn't realize there's like a bathroom down here. So she's gonna eat. Let's have her go up to their bedroom, which I remember is this one. And while she's here, let her do some online dating. I don't know if it works in university, but we'll have to see. All right. I'm being a creeper, watching while she goes to the bathroom. I don't mean to do that. And yeah, pretty much we're gonna have them do some jobs. No, we're not getting a Bonehilda. Yeah, I'm definitely gonna have her do some jobs and whatnot, and probably more Verity than anything because she doesn't have as many classes. Okay, I don't see any reason to change any of this. Office hero. Okay. That's not like a trait, that's just a thing that she is, but okay. She doesn't want to put that she's a workaholic. No, put that you're a workaholic, okay? Thank you. We don't need to lie, because then people are always like, oh, why did you lie? She wants to browse online dating profiles. Let's do that really quickly before we do anything else. We'll have her go to bed. What are you doing in here? Oh, he's cute. Miles. He's socially awkward. Party animal. Never nude. Insane. Angler. He's also a Leo. He likes lime green. Helia would enjoy that. Lewis. I don't know. More to love. She actually talked to Lewis, I think. He's a mooch. Meh. Paul. Yeah, these guys are kind of cute in their own way. Natural cook, mooch. Wow, he's got some. Well, he doesn't like children. She has children. I don't necessarily know. Okay, Walter. He has a cranky look on his face. Angler, brave, loser. Losers aren't actually as bad as they seem like they would be. Slob, natural cook. He likes rockabilly. I mean, it's not awful, but Sid server is, oh, you pain in the butt. Nope. Okay, Justin. He is a coward. He's friendly. He hates the outdoors. He's a technophobe. He's a virtuoso. No. Skip. Coward, friendly, inappropriate, maybe, neurotic, loves the cold, family-oriented, excitable. He's family-oriented, but he doesn't like children? That's really interesting. He's a snob, neurotic, neat, coward, bookworm. See, because, like, you can be family-oriented if you don't like children, like, in real life, but Sims that are family-oriented typically want to have more children. And that's why they're better at, like, teaching kids how to walk and whatnot. Socially awkward, handy, friendly. I actually like that he likes pink, and I like that he's wearing pink. Oh, and he likes lilac. I like that. Computer whiz, good. Socially awkward. Oh, hello. You're adorable, Tiberius. Sleeping bed. Okay, this is her bed. Sleep. We're gonna get them some better beds, and yeah, I will gussy up their rooms a little bit. Okay, your rebellious behavior improved your standing with the rebels. The rebels adore you. Okay, why don't you greet? Okay, say hi. Say hi. Who's that? Hank McLemore. He's got an intense look on his face. Oh, jeez. Is he a werewolf? No. His eyes aren't yellow. I don't think I have werewolves in the game. I don't think. I think I turned it so that they won't be around. Don't berate ignorance, I swear. That interaction makes me nuts. Like, it's actually not completely outside of the realm of reality. I do know. I'm like I said before, I count myself amongst sort of the quote-unquote nerds. I do know a lot of quote-unquote nerdy people, and it is it is standard practice to occasionally, not necessarily standard practice, occasionally to, be a little jerkish if someone isn't familiar with a fandom or just something, I don't know. But, it happens. Okay, she's gonna have to get back home to get set for bed so that she can go, whoa, Column, so that she can go to, where the frig am I? Okay, I gotcha. All right. Oh, there are tofu. Ew. Pass. She's too tired to serve dinner. I guess we do have to eat the tofu dog. Oh, we can have her make a microwave meal because I actually haven't had her make one before. Why don't you make ramen? What are you carrying? Oh, okay. She just like manifests it from her hand. I gotcha. And then, yeah, we'll have her learn painting, have her work on her photography. Her academic crap is still going up, which is nice. Nope, now it's going down. I spoke too soon. Eat your ramen, girl. Your skin's not dry enough. Okay, and this is her room. And you're gonna go sleep after the, actually, nope. Use, then shower, then sleep. Efficiency. Okay, well, that's it for their day. And yeah, I think we're gonna stop here. I know this episode's short. I will be recording more of these, and I will be uploading at least every third day for this particular LP. Before we go, once again, I've mentioned in several of my videos, including I think the first or second of my Monte Vista videos, and also episode 15, or Monte Vista University Life, and also episode 15 of my Let's Play The Sims 3 Monte Vista videos. In episode 15, I explain in detail, like, why sometimes I'm too sick to record. So if you wanna know, go ahead and watch that. I don't wanna belabor it again, but it is something you guys should know. I won't abandon my LPs, I won't abandon you guys. I want to continue making videos as much as possible. And I try to record way in advance, which is why sometimes I say contradictory things because I change my mind or whatever. But sometimes I am honestly just going to be too sick to record. And it's not a matter of choice. I just have to take care of myself in those instances. So yeah. Sorry to be a bummer, but thank you again so much. I can't tell you how much all of this means to me. I really can't. From the bottom of my heart, you're all wonderful. You're all awesome. And thank you again. See you later.